They've been out.
Exactly in that view that this is no better time to get hot, and that's exactly what the Blue Hens have done. And you said it, on the other side, the Seahawks have done just the opposite. And it's really amazing to say that they have gone 1-5-1 in those games. Or what? Yeah, 1-5-1. But it's also interesting to note that in four of those five games, they have the score has been decided by only one goal. So while they haven't had a strong record in those games, it has been very, very close. So UNCW can stay close.
Absolutely, Andrew. I was talking to Coach Aiden Heaney right before this game, and he said the same thing. I asked him, what's the mindset of the team right now after dropping these games? And he goes, surprisingly, Kyle, confident. You know, he says there's a difference between when you're losing games and you're playing poorly. You feel down about yourself. They feel like they've been losing games but playing well. So they're a team that's itching for a victory right now. And we'll see if they can come away with one. The sixth seed ended up making the run last year. Remember JMU? They were the sixth seed. They beat the third seed, two seed, and one seed University of Delaware here in the finals to reach the NCAA tournament. So you never know with this conference. That's what Coach Ian Hennessy was talking about. We're going to throw it to a quick break right now, but when we come back, we will have the starting lineups and your Chevrolet keys to the game right here on Ends All Access. Stick with us.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old hens and promos for future hens.
I'm on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my vengeance. Been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a one shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me is only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, permanently pit from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Welcome back. We are under the lights. That's a nice shot right there from our camera crew right here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. And right now we will bring you your starting lineup for today's match, sponsored by the Alfred Lerner College of Business and Economics for the sixth seed UNCW Seahawks. On defense for them, Matt Morgan, the freshman from Johns Creek, Georgia. Braden Smith, a sophomore from Clemens, North Carolina. And Huntley Munn, the freshman from Durham, North Carolina. At midfield in this 3-4-3 set, Joel Bylander, the freshman from Stockholm, Sweden. Kellen Foster, the junior from Cary, North Carolina. Jose Garcia, the senior from College Park, Georgia. And Ben Fisher, the freshman from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Very talented freshman that UD is going to have to watch out for. And at forward, Nathaniel Goodwin, the senior from Huntersville, North Carolina. Daniel Escobar, the senior from Cali, Columbia. And the star of this team, number 23, Colin Bonner, the senior from Fulton, Maryland. In cage for the Seahawks, Sean Melvin, the junior from Victoria, British Columbia. And at the helm of the UNCW Seahawks in his 15th season, Coach Aiden Heaney. And now for your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, the number 3 seed in this tournament. On defense, John Schroeder, the freshman from Houston, Texas. Ben Sampson, the senior from Woodbury, Minnesota. Soren Frost, the freshman from Lebanon, Pennsylvania. And Thibaut Philippe, the captain, the sophomore from Saint-Bronc, France. Ben Sampson also a captain as well. At midfield, Nick DiRienzo, the senior from Hulkesson, Delaware. Carlos Perales getting the start tonight, the sophomore from La Asodilla de Crespin, Spain. As well as Joe Dupree, the senior from Betchworth, England, and Robert Gillen, the freshman from Marlton, New Jersey. Finally, at forward for tonight for the Hens, Guillermo Delgado, the captain, the goal leader, the junior, the All-American from Tres Cantos, Spain. In goal for the Hens, leading the CAA in almost every goalie statistical category, Todd Morton, the redshirt freshman keeper from Westchester, Pennsylvania. Head coach of the University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens is Ian Hennessy. And I also forgot to mention the team leader in assists has really come on and made an impact for this team this year, offensively and defensively. That's number 23, Thomas Daviari, the junior from Vincennes, France. Once again, that starting lineup brought to you by the Alfred Lerner College of Business and Economics. Now we're going to toss it to the Chevrolet keys of the game. This will be the keys to the game for the University of Delaware. Number one, get off to a quick start. I was talking to Coach Hennessy. What does that mean? Does it mean get a goal? Does it mean limit goals? And he said, no, we want to get into our passing game. We want to make sure that we can get to our rhythm and not get thrown off guard. Number two, be effective in transition. Limit UNCW's opportunities in transition and also get a couple counterattacks of their own. Finally, deal with their front four. UNCW has a few goal scorers who can put the ball in the back of the net. We mentioned Colin Bonner, Ben Fisher, Daniel Escobar, Nathaniel Goodwin all have at least 4 goals on the season. So it'll be a tough task for this University of Delaware defense, which has really come on strong in the past 5 games.
Yeah, absolutely. They have really stepped up and shown how good they are on the backside, but nothing more to the credit of Todd Morton. Just absolutely insane in between the posts. He has been just lights out, throwing save after save after save, and he has an unbelievable rank nationally at 9 in the nation with almost an 85% save rate, and the leading in the nation has a 91% rate saving. So he's not far behind. He has done a fantastic job in between posts and will hopefully do that tonight as the lights just bear down a little bit stronger tonight.
So we mentioned our Chevrolet keys to the game. What are your keys to the game? And remember, those are brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer near you. And now we're going
to
step
up. Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level Chevy.
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
Andrew Wickman, Kyle Coulter back with you here at the press box at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Quarterfinals of the CAA tournament are about to get underway. The crowd is filled up here, the stands. On this homecoming weekend, a lot of alumni back. I saw Tobias Mueller on the far side. I was talking to him just before the game about the defense, which you see right there, rallied around Todd Morton. And it's a defense that has really congealed in the past few games. They were struggling earlier in the season, a lot of miscommunication. But Ben Sampson and Thibaut Philippe took control back there. Ryan Talbot, John Schroeder, and Soren Frost have really fallen in line really well with them. And they're just playing on another level right now, and they're going to need to be with this UNCW offense, which is capable of putting up 5-6 goals. They had a point there in the first few games where they put up 5 goals, 6 goals, 5 goals against formidable competition. So they have a chance to break out at any point, and this is going to be exciting. UNCW in their road yellows, they will be going right to left on your screen. University of Delaware in their home whites, they will be going left to right. Delaware is paced offensively by Guillermo Delgado, the All-American preseason CAA Player of the Year. 8 goals, 3 assists for him. Joe Dupree has 3 goals, 5 assists as well. Tomas Davidiardi, 2 goals and team-leading 7 assists. Then you got Danny Laguna with 4 goals. Thibaut Philippe with 3. Jaime Martinez, Carlos Perales, Ben Sampson, Ryan Talbot, all with 2. Nick DiRenzo putting in 1 as well. So a lot of different people can put the ball in the back of the net for the Hens tonight. And we see right there Daniel Escobar and Connor and Colin Bonner ready to get things going.
Kyle, if you mind, I'm going to add my own little keys to the game as we get started right here in the CAA postseason. I'm going to add my own little keys to the game for Delaware. Take advantage of history. UNCW has notoriously been not so great in CAA postseason play. Their last win in the CAA tournament came in 2009, and their last win in the quarters was in 2005. And last year they made it into the CAA tournament, were a two seed, and they lost to the number six seed, James Madison, who ended up going on to win the CA tournament. But they lost right on this field right here. And just for an overall stat, in the CAA tournament, UNCW has gone on a record of 1-15-1. So really, not that strong.
But you say all the numbers, and it's certainly very telling. But the way the CAA has gone this year, with teams falling in and out of rankings, you really never know what's going to happen. Any team on any given night could come out on top. And right now, UNCW controlling play in the opening minute. They will get the throw-in on the far side. That'll be Kellen Foster lofting it into the box. Headed back, Soren Frost, one touches it away. That'll go out of play for another Seahawk throw-in. Now back to Foster. He's going to put it into the box. And that'll be a big matchup to watch there, literally. Ben Sampson at 6'2 against Colin Bonner at 6'5 for the Seahawks. Provides a lot of height there in the box. A really impressive target, particularly for corners. We noticed they've scored 6 goals off corners this year. And Guillermo Delgado gives that one a run, but it goes out of play.
I mean, that number, six goals off of corners, is just an outstanding number. We saw Delaware finally put in their first goal off a corner, going to Thibaut Philippe as he came charging through the middle not too many weeks ago now. And that was one. UNCW has produced 6 on the season. That's just a fantastic number and a very, very winning trait if you can keep that going.
And there's Ben Fisher working on John Schroeder, freshman against freshman. And that one will go out of bounds for UNCW's first corner of the evening. Over to take it will be Jose Garcia. Here comes the cross. It's a low one. Played back to Garcia. Garcia's going to look. And now we're going to get a call there against the Seahawks. Couldn't see exactly what it was, but Delaware... we'll get the free kick from deep in their defensive third. Morton set to kick it away. Delaware looking for their first offensive possession of the evening. Carlos Perales sprinting over, but it's actually Soren Frost that comes and wins that one back. Schroeder with time, goes off his knee a little bit too much, and now back to the Seahawks. And a quick call there. Ben Sampson went for the ball, but ended up getting a little too much of the body of Daniel Escobar. So Garcia will get the free kick now. Jose Garcia with 4 assists on the year. That's good enough for third on the team, and I'd venture to guess maybe one or two of them have come off corners or free kicks. That one's curled into the box but headed right back out. Soren Frost heads it forward. Perales looking for Delgado. Delgado takes some contact from behind, gives it up. Seahawks win it back, and they'll go back to their defensive side, settle it down.
UNCW doing a good job already of controlling that ball, especially in the Delaware zone, really taking advantage of that 4-man front, using their height and speed to their advantage, and even better to say for Delaware, the defensive job, as they've been fighting off a lot of coming on from UNCW already.
Here's the near side. Munn has some room, plays it ahead. Ben Fisher with it. Smart play there defensively. Looked like Fisher might have been offsides, but no flag is up. He wins it. And stumbles as he's going for the ball. Schroeder looked like he was waiting for a call. Daviardi heads it along, but not far enough to get to Carlos Perales. Controlled by Bylander. And it goes out of play. Delaware will get a throw-in from their offensive half.
Coach Ian Hennessy said to you, Kyle, that they wanted to get off to a very early start and get things going, get into their pace, and maybe not so much just yet, but this would be the opportunity to get the ball, settle it down a little bit, settle their team down a little bit, as it's immediately sent back to UNCW hands. But this is the point in time where emotions have calmed down. There's enough time into the game where everyone can settle down a little bit. They've gotten into their stride, and this would be the time for Delaware to set their pace.
One by Nick Rienzo, lofted up to Guillermo Delgado, but that one a little too far. It goes into the hands of Sean Melvin. It was a good idea. Delgado's been waiting for that run. That one's chipped ahead. Soren Frost gets ahead to it. It goes out of play and hits the at UD Blue Hens Twitter and Instagram handle, in case you're wondering where to follow them. Joe Dupree heads it forward. Delgado plays it back to Dupree. It deflects off his chest. Dupree and Delgado working the run here. Nick DiRienzo joining from the back end. There's Dupree with the cross. It's low, and it's cleared away by Huntley Munn. Out of play, Delaware will get the throw.
And that's what Delaware does best, those quick runs where they have the speed and they have the power to put one in the back of the net. Unfortunately, there were too many Seahawks waiting for that oncome, but definitely a great opportunity already for the Hens.
So now it's one back by UNCW over the midfield line. Robert Gillen wins it back. Now one touched along, right back. Tomas Deviardi getting his first action. Now to Gillen. Here's a good build-up. John Schroeder coming from the right side. DiRienzo. And Deviardi expected Delgado to do something different. Goes back to Melvin, who clears it away. Call there against the Seahawks and Daniel Escobar. It'll be a free kick from just around the midline. We see Ben Sampson there wearing the captain's armband. Listed as a senior, but he will be back for one more year, which is really exciting stuff for this Delaware defense. With the whole starting back four, with at least one more year of eligibility. Soren Frost and John Schroeder, both freshmen. There's Schroeder. And the offsides flag was up. Guillermo Delgado couldn't get back past the line quick enough, as you see the line judge there.
Not many times have we seen offside calls on Delaware here at this stadium.
Very
We've
true.
Often seen offside calls go the other way, so a very rare and interesting offside call on Guillermo Delgado, a very smart player.
He's so good at towing that line and knowing when to get back on, but I think that pass came a little too quickly for him to get back. But anyway, Delaware showing a little bit more life offensively here in the last few minutes. Huntley Munn. That one played forward. The offsides flag was not raised. He might have just been waiting because there was no offensive play to be made. Morton came out and took it away. The winner of this game will move on to face Elon in the semifinal match up in Hofstra. Delgado giving that a run, but Melvin comes out and clears it confidently. That one's headlocked by Bonner. Soren Frost takes it away. Morales tries to chip it along, and that one goes out. Braden Smith here near side to Munn. Munn chips it ahead. Looking for Bonner. It's headed back the way it came, and Sampson is able to corral it in. Some athleticism there from the main official. Soren Frost looking to get a quick run going, but too far for Perales to get to. Deviardi gets a foot in there. Now Perales controls. Good through ball to Delgado. Dupree and Corrales are in the middle. Delgado cross a little bit behind Joe Dupree, who has to come back and get it at the edge of the box. DiRienzo Dupree touches it along. And it looked like he wanted to take a shot. Got some contact, pushed his body away from the target, and it'll go out for a goal kick. Another good-looking run there from Delaware's offense.
And another good-looking stand from the UNCW defense. The only two opportunities that Delaware have had really have been that one and the breakaway by Guillermo Delgado just a few minutes before. And really, UNCW doing a good job of keeping this really hot offense at bay.
Absolutely. This UNCW defense giving up just over a goal a game, 1.1 in fact. Delgado applying the pressure. UNCW able to break it. Kept in bounds by Fisher. We'll play it back to Garcia. UNCW patient here. That was Matt Morgan who played it out wide to Foster. Morgan with it again now. Now Delaware coming in and applying a little pressure. Morgan plays it forward, looking for Bonner to make a play, but it goes to the head of Thibaut Philippe, who was trying to hit it to Soren Frost, but a little too hard off the head of the Frenchman. It goes out of play. Foster to throw. Now Munn. Coming up from his left back position to help the attack. Bonner plays it forward. That's a nice through ball. There's the cross, and it's deflected away by Ben Sampson just at the last moment before it reached Daniel Escobar. So a good saving play there by the captain. And it'll be the second corner of the night for the Seahawks.
It was an extremely nice play by Ben Sampson because Colin Bonner was just 3 feet behind him, and if it went past Ben Sampson, Colin Bonner had a good foot on it and a lot of open net behind Todd Morton.
So they like to go with a short corner again. Here's the cross. Morton comes out and punches it away. They go back towards Perales. Let's see if they can do the second key of the game. Make some plays in transition. Here's Joe Dupree. Nice step over move to his left. Plays it forward. Carlos Perales. Can he get to it before it goes out of bounds? He's able to save it. Number 7 keeps it in. Works it back towards the middle of the field. Robert Gillen is waiting. Chips it out wide. Davey Arty, the assist master. Delgado with a shot to go! It's 1-0! Guillermo Delgado with his 9th of the year! The captain delivers. The assist from Tomas Davey Arty, his 8th of the year. And the University of Delaware fighting Blue Hens up 1-0.
A fantastic goal, and you say it in transition, that's exactly what they do. They take it, and a fantastic assist waiting for Guillermo Delgado, who loves those chip passes up for him, just has to tip it off the foot and right into the back of the right corner. A 1-0 lead, early 1-0 lead, absolutely take advantage of those early strikes, and Delaware really, really firing on all cylinders.
And to quote the great Yogi Berra, looks like deja vu all over again. When these two teams played here just 2 weeks ago, Delaware scored in the 15th minute, and would you look at what it is right now? No, 14th minute, excuse me, now it's the 13th minute. So very similar goal-scoring patterns here. It took Delaware a little bit of time to get into it. They established their passing, were able to make a play in transition. There's Robert Gillen. Beautiful chip out to Davey Arty. The curling pass, Delgado with the run and chips it on expertly over Melvin. Had no chance. Beautiful job. And a nice new graphic there for right here from Hens All Access, courtesy of Brad Wolak, who's directing tonight.
Perfect timing for a big, big game.
Tomas Davey Arty transferred here this year. Has been a catalyst for this offense, obviously with 8 assists now on the season. And Guillermo Delgado, he delivers time and time again in big situations. He shines in the postseason. We've seen it the past 2 years. Schroeder plays that ahead, looking for Dupree, but it's headed away by Braden Smith.
Kyle, we were talking about this before the game. The UNCW offense really firing on all cylinders thanks to, well, I should say early on in the season, thanks to Colin Bonner. But he was the leading points scorer in the CAA, and now thanks to that goal, Guillermo Delgado has taken that lead with 21 points and is now ahead of Colin Bonner, who has 20 points. Colin Bonner with 7 goals, 6 assists on the season.
Also another milestone achieved for the junior, Guillermo Delgado. He has moved into second place all-time in Delaware's history with goals with 36, just past John McCloskey for second all-time. Still 11 goals behind Mike Biggs, who has the all-time lead with 47, but something tells me Guillermo Delgado might reach that by the time he graduates.
Thankfully, we still have another year of him.
And now he is also tied with John McCloskey for second all-time in career points with 82. And he's only a junior. So now UNCW looking to answer. Jose Garcia plays it forward. Looking for Bonner. It tails away from number 23 and goes into the corner. Thibaut Philippe just puts his right foot to it, gets it out of play. It'll be a throw-in. Foster comes up to take it.
As for UNCW, that was a really disheartening goal because their defense has been playing so well all game. It's just when Delaware is able to pick the one flaw in it, they're able to score, and now you're trying to play catch-up. And a game that's been controlled by good defense, UNCW is going to have to play a lot of catch-up in this only 1-0 game.
And Sampson's able to clear that one away before it reaches danger, but UNCW still with it. Foster plays it in. That one's going to sail in and out of the box. Schroeder gets it in the corner, is able to turn on it and clear it away. But Bylander heads it back towards Delaware's direction. Daviardi plays it forward, looking for Joe Dupree. Dupree's able to get to it, touches it along. Daviardi is there. He's going to try to chip the keeper, and it goes, hits the top of the net. That was some beautiful passing all the way from the back end. And it would have been an absolute stunner of a goal. But once again, in transition, we just saw it right there. Delaware capitalizing, getting good shots. And we'll get another look at that right now. The touch by Joe Dupree in the first place was absolutely stellar. And Melvin, who probably got a good look at it, that he didn't know, he knew he didn't have to go up and punch it, but he would definitely took a nervous look back at it because it was coming down dangerously. Bonner plays it out wide. Chipped in, looking for Bylander. UNCW still with it now. Corner of the box. Morton's got to come out, and he smothers the ball. Beautiful play there by the redshirt freshman. I believe that was Nathaniel Goodwin coming up, looking to make a play, and it's given away. Escobar to his right. Turn. Bylander with it. Now back to Huntley Mund. Mund able to control it again. And when we were speaking with both coaches prior to this match, I asked what your team's keying on today, what's one thing is important, and both echoed need to take care of the ball. Cannot turn it over like we just saw there. Almost led to a really good chance for UNCW, but make sure you limit your turnovers and don't give, because both these teams respect each other tremendously. They know how talented each team is, and you don't want to give them any extra opportunities that they wouldn't already generate for themselves. And here's some good linking play. Schroeder, near side, gets it up to Delgado, flicks it back. The idea was certainly there. It would have been really nice. Delgado was trying to do a little back heel to John Schroeder, who now has to try to get back to his defensive position. Nick DiRienzo recognizes it and settles in. Now Bonner making a run, vacating that space left by Schroeder. Now plays it back to Munn. Bylander. Now works it back. UNCW settling it. Smith finds Escobar in the center of the field. Foster, one touch back to Garcia. Daviardi applying the pressure. UNCW very patient. That one headed along. Really nice play. Here's Fisher. Corner of the box. Sampson looking to recover. Fisher trying to get it to his right foot. Now cuts back left. Morton comes out and gets it away from Fisher. And then Gillen comes out and finishes the job. Beautiful, aggressive play. And now Delaware's got a chance in transition. It's a 3-on-3. DePuy plays it out wide to Carlos Perales. And the midfielders from UNCW recover. And they end up giving it right back to UNCW. Beautiful job there by the Seahawks midfielders to come back.
Let's go back to the Delaware defensive side. Two fantastic plays coming out of goal for Todd Morton in the matter of 3 minutes. Coming out with all confidence, blocking away two very good chances, especially the last one by Ben Fisher, who is a leading goal scorer, especially as a freshman, someone to definitely watch out for in the next 4 years. But Todd Morton just taking advantage of all aspects of his talented game and doing a great job of blocking that ball and keeping that ball out of the goal.
Now Escobar with some room, now turns back. Robert Gillen working on defense, plays it ahead to Fisher. Schroeder is there again. Fisher still with it. Cuts back, trying to keep it on his feet. Schroeder applying a lot of pressure. And it goes out of play. Number two with some stand-up D right there. We're going to get a replay now of the save. See Fisher on the run there, and Morton just gets a touch to it, and then Gillen comes over and helps out his keeper. Garcia heads it back. His offense's direction. Nice body control there. Munn back to Garcia. And due to Delaware's pressure, they'll have to retreat back to the defensive side. Taken away, but right back to UNCW. Nick DiRienzo was able to get a touch, but a little too much. Now Morgan coming up out of the back end. Bonner looking to play it on to Goodwin, but now it's taken away. Perales keeps it on his feet. Morgan trying to make a play, and he does. Matt Morgan, from his backside, able to make that play.
Neither team known for that physical play. Nothing really defines them on physical play, but tonight it seems a little bit more used, I should say, the physicality, and we've seen it already. There's been a few pushes for some balls, and thankfully, no yellow cards called yet, but definitely a little bit of extra aggressiveness tonight as they play for a game that is, from now on, a must-win.
And that's postseason play, Andrew. You got to think maybe, I don't know if any team out of this conference, maybe besides, I don't even think Elon or Hofstra could get an automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. This is going to be the champion. It's going to go and get that coveted spot in the national tournament. That one's played out wide. Schroeder coming up to try to get it. It's taken away by Munn. Munn still with it. Nick DiRienzo slides in and ends up touching Munn last. It'll be Delaware's ball. Quick throw by Schroeder. He'll take it back. We see Nick DiRienzo there, the senior. Had an absolutely beautiful goal against JMU on senior day. To Beau Philippe. Works in the middle of the field. There's Joe Dupree. Turns on that second gear. Still with it now. Trying to split three defenders. Still with it on his feet, and he finally gets tripped up. Now it's going back the other way. Played ahead. Fisher with a full head of steam, and Morton will let it roll into the box where he can safely gather it. And now a long throw out to John Schroeder. Beautiful throw. Schroeder. And thought Delgado was going to keep making the run. Just a split second off in that communication.
And a split second is all what this game is about. And thankfully they were able to take of that fantastic split second just a few minutes ago and put them up 1-0 as we see Delaware up 1-0 on the scoreboard here in this CAA quarterfinal against the UNCW Seahawks. Unfortunately, that split second didn't work out in their favor. But they've been going to that up-ahead pass for Guillermo Delgado in the past few weeks, all season I should say, and trying to do it once again. Not too successful on this one though.
Thibaut Philippe lets it sail over his head. Go back towards the midfield line. Once again, fans, thank you to listening. Thank you for listening to this Hens All Access broadcast powered by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer nearest you. Alongside Andrew Wickman, I'm Kyle Coulter. Now out wide. Here's Goodwin playing it forward. Goodwin making a run, crosses it in, goes over the head of Bonner. Escobar has it in the box, and now it's tipped away by Philippe. Foster, stutter steps, now plays it ahead to Munn. Munn, through ball up to Fisher, crossed towards the mouth of the cage. Morton just has to come out and flick it away. There was a lot of spin on that ball, kind of spinning away from the keeper. And Sampson heads that one away, but not out of the woods yet. Munn looks to take a shot. It's deflected down. Now another shot by Bylander, and that one rolls safely to Todd Morton. So UNCW frantically trying to put the ball in the back of the net. They had a good few opportunities there. We're going to take another look at that in just a moment.
Yeah, a lot of action up there right at the front of the net. We're going to see right here a lot of opportunities. Another fantastic come out of the post or come out of the goal for Todd Morton. And just an incredible job yet again.
Headed along.
Redshirt freshman.
Delgado, that touch got a little bit further away from than he would have liked, but Schroeder's coming up to help out the attack. Delgado still with it. Flicks it to himself. Now to the box. The cross. It's low and it's intercepted. Nick DiRienzo has it now. Plays it out wide to Schroeder. Schroeder with some room to the corner decides to cross it instead. Far side. There's a shot from Soren Frost coming up out of the back end. Couldn't get enough on it. And it rolls to Melvin, but again, Delaware creating opportunities in transition after they get a good stop by their keeper, strong stop by their defense. They look to turn it around and capitalize on it the other way. Unable to do so there, but we've seen it work for them so far tonight.
It's interesting where UNCW has had opportunities that last. I should say. For lack of better terms, a long time in the Delaware zone and a few attacks coming at one time, whereas Delaware, they have one opportunity and they take advantage of it. They haven't had long-lasting opportunities down in the UNCW zone, but when they do, they make the most of it, and that's why they have the lead right now, 1-0.
And a misstep there. It'll be a break now for the Hens. Played along. Guillermo Delgado. Melvin is out. He goes to his right. This one's a certainty. Delgado, and it's tipped away at the mouth of the goal. Not so certain after all. My goodness. What a play from number 14, Braden Smith. The goal was wide open, ladies and gentlemen. Delgado was licking his lips, ready to put it in the back of the net. We see it now. He had to gather himself. He went a little too far by. And my goodness, what a play.
Just no words, absolutely no words.
CAA postseason soccer, that's what it's all about right there, the hustle.
That's the best way to put it, just an incredible play.
Daviardi curls it in, another chance for Delaware. Thibaut Philippe in the box, it's headed away, and Bylander finally kicks it out to Fisher. Wow. And now a counterattack opportunity here. Joe Dupree running step for step with Bonner, and Bonner had to try to put it forward to maybe get a step on the much shorter Dupree, and then John Schroeder came in to help out. And now we're going to get a substitution. Looks like Nathaniel Goodwin is coming out. And Calvin Cromer, the sophomore from Cary, North Carolina, coming in.
Kyle, that had everybody on the edge of their seats. Just an incredible play. Took everyone by surprise that the UNC defender came out of nowhere and kicked it, kept it out of the net. My goodness, everyone thought that it was a 2-0 game.
I still can't believe what I just witnessed. What a play of athleticism and just wanting it just a little bit more. And it was a absolutely perfect through ball from the back end. I believe it was Dupree who made the pass. But if this game ends up, if UNC ends up, UNCW ends up tying this game, that we're gonna look at that play right there. Here's Cromer. He's able to get around Schroeder. Cromer runs right into Ben Sampson. Was looking for a call, but none was there. It was good stand-up defense there by the senior captain. Cromer scored his first goal in UNCW's last game against Charlotte, his first since September 12th. And there's a nice play by Cromer again. He gets held up, so it'll be a free kick. What basically amounts to a corner, just a little more upfield, a little bit closer.
And Garcia will come over to take it.
There's the play by Cromer running right into Ben Sampson. Bonner was looking for a call, but there was really, really nothing there. Garcia with the cross into the box, and it sails by everybody and goes into the corner where Daviardi is waiting for it, and Delaware, as they've done all night, looking to turn it the other way.
It's funny, that was a very good through ball, and everyone was crashing the goal, and they left one thing behind, and that was the ball. and they come up empty-handed.
Looks like Ryan Talbot's going to step in for Nick DiRienzo. Talbot has played in now his 18th game, the sophomore. So now under 14 minutes remaining in the first half, Delaware still with the one goal lead courtesy of the goal from number 9, Guillermo Delgado. Escobar. Delgado leaves it back, was hoping Daviardi would make a run, but Garcia is able to take it away. Fisher working on Talbot. Talbot gets a foot to it. Plays it back to Schroeder. Smart play. Schroeder lofts it ahead. Was looking for Delgado, but that one goes a little bit awry. And Delgado goes down hard, but looks like he'll be all right getting up. Thought he might have gotten the wind knocked out of him there, but he's all right. Fisher, Daviardi coming back. Physical play continues. And now the call against the Seahawks. Good play by Robert Gillen coming over to get the first touch on it. So it'll be a free kick for the Hens.
And this is when frustration turns into aggressiveness, and that's when things can get ugly. UNCW in, I should say, sixth in the nation with red cards, four red cards on the entire season. And that's only behind the number one overall with seven red cards on the season. So when it gets rough, it gets extremely rough for the UNCW Seahawks. And that's something that Delaware not only needs to watch out for, but really be mindful of, because that could hurt them literally and figuratively.
Let me take a look at the crowd here at Stuart Suzanne Grant Stadium. Almost packed here for postseason play. It's a chilly night here on this November evening, homecoming weekend. And now UNCW with a chance. That ball goes forward. John Schroeder does a really nice job using his body to shield the ball. Now Daviardi with it, looking to work with Talbot. Talbot is looking to feed it into Daviardi, but Munn was able to get a foot to it. Sampson. Sampson with it again. Gillen, now pressure coming. Good give and go. Gillen with it over the midfield line. Plays it ahead, looking for Delgado. Can he get a touch on it before Melvin does? And Melvin comes and gets ahead to it. And him and Delgado collide, but give each other a tap on the way back. Soren Frost gathers it, redistributes out, but it goes right to Bylander. Perales putting some pressure on. Giving away, Joe Dupree in the midfield. Plays it over. Talbot has it, tries to tow it along to get Delgado, but it's taken away. Back heel. Garcia transfers it to the near side. Cromer. Bylander again. Plays it ahead for Bonner. Haven't called Colin Bonner's name much tonight. Ben Sampson's done a nice job keeping him in check. There's the cross. Just goes through the box, but Ben Fisher is there to gather it. Soren Frost comes over to play him. Fisher, cross. It's there, but Thibaut Philippe's head gets in the way of its intended target, and it goes back out of bounds for another UNCW throw.
UNCW mounting these really strong opportunities as they now send in two new legs. And when UNCW has these strong opportunities, it tests the will and it tests the strength of the Delaware's defense, and they have just done an incredible job standing up to these really strong opportunities from the Seahawks all night.
Number 24, Ryan Nally, the sophomore from Berlin, Maryland, into the game as well. One more substitution for UNCW. I'm looking to see they're 18 or 19, just trying to see the number on the back there. It's number 18, thank you. Jordan Cordero, the senior from Jacksonville, North Carolina. So now another corner. It'll be Garcia. Electing to go with a traditional corner this time for Bonner. Headed towards, and it's kept out! And finally goes into the back of the goal. Another goal off the corner. It's number 14. Braden Smith finally getting the final touch to it. The seventh goal off a corner for UNCW this season. It was a tremendous play by Robert Gillen to keep it out initially, but too much determination there from UNCW offensively. We definitely want to take another look at that one. But we're tied up at one here in this CAA quarterfinal match. They've had a couple crosses. We'll see it right here. Bonner gets the first head to it. Morton has to come out. Gillen kicks it ahead. It might have gone in right there, but anyway, Braden Smith sticks with it. The defenseman, the sophomore from Clemens, North Carolina, puts it in. For him, his second goal of the season, and that was a big one.
You know, when you have so much talent on the corner kicks, what best way to take advantage of it than in a point where you need a goal to equalize in the CAA tournament, and just sticking with it, that really has been was the best part of that play. UNCW sticking with it after Robert Gillen doing a great job of keeping it out initially, and Braden Smith keeping it on his feet and able to put it in the back of the net to tie this one up.
And let's not forget who saved the goal. Also Braden Smith. So he keeps the game at 1-0 and then ties it at 1-1 pretty much on a solo effort. So the sophomore playing out of his mind tonight. And we are tied up at 1 with approaching 8 minutes to go in the first half. It'll be a free kick. Davey Hardy about to take the kick. And Jose Garcia just looking to waste a little time. Not sure what he was trying to accomplish there. Davey Hardy, number 23. Delaware looking to regain the lead. Here's the ball in, and that one travels to Melvin. No Blue Hen able to get its foot to it. So we're under 8 minutes remaining in the first half. Near side, here's Nally. Bylander. That one's played forward. Thibaut Philippe heads it back. Ben Sampson is waiting. Gets it to Robert Gillen. Gillen spoots it towards Delaware's goal. UNCW looking to build up another attack here. Thibaut Philippe comes away and kicks that one out of play. It'll be a UNCW throw. Smith. Cromer still with it. Now plays it out wide. That's Cordero. Cordero in the middle of the field. Tries to thread the needle there back to Cromer, but nothing was there. Garcia plays it ahead, and that goes right to Morton, who's now going to look to start a counterattack. Boots it forward. Delgado is waiting there with Smith. Delgado chested along, was looking for Dupree, but now Gillen's able to trap it. Good pass there from Talbot out to Schroeder. Delgado plays it back to himself. Now has some room and plenty of speed. Ah, tries to nutmeg Nally there, but is left on the spice rack. Nally here on the near side. That won't go out of play. Throw in for John Schroeder. Thibaut Philippe plays it ahead looking for Perales. Daviardi coming looking to win it back, but it's kept by Bylander, who retreats. Nally. Cromer. Jab steps forward, now keeps it on his foot. Still with it there, gets around Schroeder. Nally, and finally kicked away by Schroeder. Number two, Schroeder, never out of a play. He got beat there initially, but is able to get his body back in position. Nally. Back to Bylander. He wanted to play it into Cordero, but ends up playing it back to Garcia. Now ahead, one touch on. There's a nice idea, but Morton comes out, is able to gather it.
This half has been filled with extreme excitement. It took a while for the Hens to get started, but they got everything going at once, and Guillermo Delgado put a fantastic goal in the back of the net to take a 1-0 lead, and for a while it looked like Delaware was going to hold that lead for a very long time, and then UNCW was able to crash the net on a fantastic corner, what they've done, been able to do well all season. This game stands at 1-0 as this half has quickly ticked away to under 4.5 minutes left in the CAA quarterfinal.
It's gone by very quickly. But no shortage of excitement. And we have 4 minutes remaining here in the first half. That one's played ahead, Delgado, but a little too far there from Daviardi. How that ball got through in the first place, I have no idea. Nally. Played ahead by Smith. Ben Sampson settles under it and heads it. Looking for Schroeder, but it goes off the side and out of play. One more sub now for UNCW. Bonner checks back into the game. He takes out Bylander. UNCW looking to make a couple more offensive pushes here in the waning minutes of the first half. Thibaut Philippe puts that one out on the sideline for a throw-in. Nally. Cromer tries to split the double team. It goes off Talbot and out of play. Nally again. See the scoreboard there right in the background. That one goes out on the end line. It'll be another Seahawk corner. It'll be their fourth of the night. Their first two, they elected to go short corners, and they didn't get anything out of it. Then the one they scored on, they went traditional and ended up putting the ball in the back of the net. Here's Garcia. There's the cross. It's in. Soren Frost heads it away. Perales with it. Dupree comes back. Leaves it for himself. Looking to turn. And he gets bodied before he can get to the ball. Looking for a call. Got none. Daviardi elevates himself. Gets it back to Gillen. Now Dupree has it. Daviardi finds Talbot. Schroeder coming to help out the run. Plays it to Schroeder. And Schroeder tried to leave it, and maybe hopefully it would get around him. But Delaware gets the throw. 1 minute and 40 seconds remaining here in the first half. Delgado turns to his left. Still with it. Now plays it out wide. Soren Frost coming out of the back end. Daviardi gives way for Schroeder. Talbot keeps it in play beautifully. Nice drag back. Still with it now. And now he gets the call. Talbot did a real nice job there controlling it, shielding him, shielding the ball with his body. 1 minute and 5 seconds. Delaware with a great chance here. Daviardi, the lefty, from the near side.
It sounded initially like he wasn't going to get that call, but thankfully he did, because that was a definite grab.
Here we go. There's the cross. It's dangerous. Towards the net, and it goes out of play. Looks like it went off the Seahawks. 50 seconds left. Delaware will have time for another corner. It'll be Daviardi, the lefty. He'll have an in-swinging corner. Thibaut Philippe, Ben Sampson up to help provide some height in the box. Here's the cross. And Melvin comes out, is able to take that away. Still 30 seconds, enough time for UNC to mount a counter if they wish. Bonner plays it ahead. Ben Sampson, it's a foot race. John Fortone, now Cordero in the box. And a little too much of a touch there from Jordan Cordero, and Todd Morton comes out and makes another save, and he'll look content to end this half with the ball in midair.
Boy, as time ticks away, UNCW does their best UD impression and really tries to create a fantastic transition coming off of that UD's corner attempt, and really nothing to show for it as Todd Morton once again does a great job of coming out of goal and grabbing the ball.
So an absolutely thrilling first half here here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Delaware got on the board in the 13th minute with a goal from Guillermo Delgado. Tomas Daviardi with the assist. And then about 20 minutes later, Braden Smith putting the ball past Todd Morton off a corner. And that's where we stand right now, 1-1. And it's a 6-3 matchup, but both these teams playing like they're even right now.
Well, they need to play like that because it's a do or die, like you said, opening this game up, and that's how they played all game. And I would, for the first half, all things considered, Braden Smith gets the MVP for the first half, saving that unbelievable run by Guillermo Delgado, which almost was an assured goal, and then putting one in as Jimmy Smith is now standing by Coach Ian Hennessy. Jimmy, what does Coach have to say?
Thank you, guys. Here with head coach Ian Hennessy. Coach, 1-1 after one half. This is exactly what you expect. Such a good team in UNCW. You got your goal from your leader. What did that do to your team in the first half?
It was good. It was an important goal because, credit to UNCW, they've had the lion's share of possession. But we've got the most shots and most chances, and that was an important goal to get for us in transition. We talked about how organized both teams would be, and we kind of figured a goal like that would come from that or a set piece, so it's kind of gone as planned.
Yeah, the goal that you gave up on your end to tie it back up, what went wrong on that play?
Set pieces. You know, 30% of goals are scored off set pieces. They have a very good senior, Colin Bonner, very dangerous, very tall lad, very good on the corner kicks and free kicks, and they made good use of him to get a good goal for them.
You talked about possession not being in your favor. How do you get that back, and how do you right the ship and get a win here?
I think we just have to sharpen up our passing. You know, we're known for being a team that can pass from A to B, and today we're just a little bit off, you know, so we're happy to go in with a tie at this point, and hopefully in the second half we'll see a better quality of passing.
Well, Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
That's head coach Ian Hennessy. Guys, back to you. After one, it's 1-1.
Hey, thanks a lot, Jimmy. And Ian Hennessy, we heard him right there. He didn't seem too down on his team. And we talked about set pieces. We talked about how important they are, how crucial they are. And he mentioned the second Chevy key to the game that we mentioned at the beginning. How can you capitalize on transition? We've seen Delaware do it time and time again in that first half. Obviously, getting that one goal to put them up, and then UNCW made it even. And he mentioned 30% of goals. 30% of goals come on set pieces. For UNCW, a telling stat: 50% of their goals have come this season in the first 30 minutes of the second half. So they are certainly a second half team. They're good at making adjustments. Coach Heaney has done so, and that's when they scored here when they were here 2 weeks ago. So that's where we stand right now, 1-1. We are going to toss it to break. We'll be right back in a few minutes with more first half analysis and the start of the second half right here on Hens All Access.
beloved annual Youth Cheer Day event at Delaware Stadium is back for another year. Don't wait until the last minute. Event registration is open and filling quickly for the Delaware football home finale on Saturday, November 14th. No cheerleading experience needed. Registration includes a pregame clinic with the Delaware cheerleaders, followed by an on-field halftime performance for all to enjoy. For details and to register, visit bluehens.com.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Being a Blue Hen to me is just about giving everything you have, and whether that's your time and your energy for your teammates or in the community, it's important to be ambitious and passionate about what you do, and that kind of love that you have and that yet you show on the field every Wednesday and Saturday for me is inspiring to the people around us that come to the games and see us out in the community, and that's something really special that we have as a student athlete here to be able to showcase our talents and our passion to a wider audience. And I think that's something that's really hit home for me being a student athlete here is the amount of love that's shown from the staff here at the university and athletics and the coaches and just the community come out to games and support us is something that I don't think I'll experience for the rest of my life. Looking back on my career, I can't believe how nervous I was the first game playing in a Blue Hen uniform. I got the start at center back against Duke University in a crazy game. Unfortunately, I played two games my freshman year before I broke my foot, but looking back now on that time, I viewed it as a negative. But looking back now at that time, it really was a positive in my career because I got to stay one more year here at UD and experience the awesomeness that they have to offer. And I really am thankful that I've had these 4 years. I know that there are moments that I've made here that I'll remember for the rest of my life with a smile on my face. And I'm thankful to everyone who's contributed to that. And I really think that the ability to put on that uniform and take the field and be an inspiration to those at the university and in the whole state of Delaware is really something special that I haven't felt before. And it instills like a sense of pride as you step on the field and you really want to show them something so you can inspire others to greatness.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
I'm on a hill, King Kendrick, resurrecting my finches, been dissecting your motor mouth till I break down the engine. This ain't a one shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, probably leaping from God.
When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
Globetrotters!
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
We'll be right back.
beloved annual Youth Cheer Day event at Delaware Stadium is back for another year. Don't wait until the last minute. Event registration is open and filling quickly for the Delaware football home finale on Saturday, November 14th. No cheerleading experience needed. Registration includes a pregame clinic with the Delaware cheerleaders, followed by an on-field halftime performance for all to enjoy. For details and to register, visit bluehens.com.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Being a Blue Hen to me is just about giving everything you have, and whether that's your time and your energy for your teammates or in the community, it's important to be ambitious and passionate about what you do, and that kind of love that you have and that you show on the field every Wednesday and Saturday for me is inspiring to the people around us that come to the games and see us out in the community, and that's something really special that we have as a student athlete here to be able to showcase our talents and our passion to a wider audience. And I think that's something that's really hit home for me, being a student athlete here, is the amount of love that's shown from the staff here at the University and Athletics and the coaches and just the community to come out to games and support us is something that I don't think I'll experience for the rest of my life. Looking back on my career, I can't believe how nervous I was the first game playing in a Blue Hen uniform. I got the start at center back against Duke University in a crazy game. Unfortunately, I played two games my freshman year before I broke my foot, but looking back now on that time, I viewed it as a negative, but looking back now at that time, it really was a positive in my career because I get to stay one more year here at UD and experience the awesomeness that they have to offer. And I really am thankful that I've had these 4 years. I know that there are moments that I've made here that I'll remember for the rest of my life with a smile on my face. And I'm thankful to everyone who's contributed to that, and I really think that the ability to put on that uniform and take the field and be an inspiration to those at the university and in the whole state of Delaware is really something special that I haven't felt before, and it instills like a sense of pride as you step on the field and you really want to show them something so you can inspire others to greatness.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
Kendrick, resurrecting my finches, been dissecting your modem up till I break down the engine. This ain't a one shot, this a relevant henchman. See my opponent, then cease your existence. See, it's gonna take a whole lot of y'all to kill me. I never die, my pedigree apparently only to idolize. Ahead of me, it's only my future and idle time. Longevity, I gotta get used to making you mine. You telling me I only get used to living is fine. You can never live in my shoes, probably leaping from God. When the sun goes down, I scream loud, sleep when I die.
Company, so I need to collect your phone so you can't post pictures. Okay, how does it feel to not be connected?
My chest hurts.
Well, let me give your phones back. Let me show you a better way to keep connected. The 2016 Chevy Cruze offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi that connects up to 7 devices.
So this thing puts out its own signal?
Yes.
This is next level, Chevy.
This is where you won't believe becomes you'll never forget.
Returning to the Bob Carpenter Center, March 8th at 7. For tickets, log on to Ticketmaster.com.
We'll be right back.
The beloved annual Youth Cheer Day event at Delaware Stadium is back for another year. Don't wait until the last minute. Event registration is open and filling quickly for the Delaware football home finale on Saturday, November 14th. No cheerleading experience needed. Registration includes a pregame clinic with the Delaware cheerleaders, followed by an on-field halftime performance for all to enjoy. For details and to register, visit bluehens.com.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware men's soccer. We are here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium on this chilly November evening. It is the CAA quarterfinals. It is Andrew Wickman. I'm Kyle Coulter. It is tied 1-1 between the 6-seed UNCW Seahawks and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, the 3-seed in this year's tournament. A beautiful shot there of Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. The Blue Hens in the far right corner got things started. Guillermo Delgado put a ball in the back of the net off the Tomas Deviardi cross to go up 1-0. And then off a corner, about 20 minutes later, Braden Smith put the ball in the back of the net. And we are tied now at 1-1. Braden Smith also made a game-saving play. And we take a look. That just happened right at the end of the first half. With 10 seconds left, maybe, Cordero was about to put that one in. And Morton, as he's done consistently today, come out, made aggressive plays, and stolen a goal away from UNCW.
Let me just say something. For all of those tuning in the second half, thank you for joining us, first off. But second off, you missed a fantastic first half.
What were you doing those first 45 minutes?
In all honesty, that was one of the most well-played first halves of both teams. Not just one-sided or whatever. This was 45 minutes of fantastic soccer on both ends produced, and just one of the most amazing things to watch. It was fun for us to call, too.
It certainly was, Andrew, and I can only imagine that the next 45 minutes, and maybe more, considering the history that these two teams have, will be just as exciting.
That's right, Kyle.
And we are about to get underway here in the second 45 minutes of play. Delaware will get the ball to start.
You mentioned it right before the kick of the first half. Last time these two teams met was right here on this same field, and going into overtime was 1-1, and they ended up tying in double overtime. So they're not too shy of this one score and shy of overtime.
That one sails over the head of Talbot, but Schroeder is able to corral it. Now Dupree, he's going to take a shot. Might have been a ball into Delgado, but it's deflected before it reaches his target anyway. Corrales gets dispossessed. I keep joining his two names, Carlos Corrales. Maybe I'll just call him that from now on. I don't know if he'd be too fond of that. Carlos Corrales, anyway, gets dispossessed, and the ball goes back to the Seahawks. Now booted ahead. Ben Sampson always in the right position. Bonner heads it forward to Goodwin. Morton's out of the cage. The offsides flag is up. And that ball roll out of play anyway.
Just like Coach Hennessy said for the first half, it's going to be key that Delaware gets going early in the second half as well, because if there's anything to be said about the first half, UNCW probably has the momentum heading into the second half, coming off of that very good goal off the corner, and then almost another goal-scoring opportunity with 10 seconds left, as we saw the replay just before the start of this second half.
And we mentioned before going to break, as there's a through ball to Bonner. I'll get to that stat later. Deviardi comes back. Morton comes out and makes the save. And it's headed back. Fisher to his left. Plays it ahead. And now out wide. Chipped along. Nice looking ball. Edge of the box. And it's stopped by Ben Sampson before it can reach the center. I was going to say that UNCW scored 31 goals this season. And 15 of them have come in the first 30 minutes of the second half. So they come out strong in the second 45 minutes, and we saw them almost get a goal right there.
But Todd Morton, we say his name so many times, but it's so worth it because he is just so good at what he does. Really a true asset to this Delaware defense. So thankful to have him this season, and so thankful to have him again next season.
And the season after that.
And after that, that's right.
Now Delaware. Looking to build up some play. Deviardi gets taken down. No call. Bylander. Plays it out wide. A little bit behind Foster, who has to come back. Morgan. Foster. UNCW trying to win their first CAA tournament since 2009. That's their only conference championship. And they have only won one quarterfinal match. We're talking about the stats that aren't exactly in their favor historically. And they've been in the CAA CAA postseason play the last four seasons now, if you include this one, and they made it to the semifinals the last 2 years. Those were both by virtue of a bye. So the quarterfinal drought now at 10, quarterfinal win drought now at 10 years. They're trying to change that right now, tied with the three seed. UNCW trying to duplicate what JMU did last year, knocking off the three seed, two seed, and one seed on their way to a CAA championship. And it's certainly possible in this conference. So much talent. And I believe at least four teams have been in and out of the national rankings all season. You can throw Delaware in that mix. So very talented Morton playing with fire a little bit there.
You know, it's true, Kyle. Heading into the CAA postseason, it's really whoever is playing best in those four games set. Because really, it's anybody's game. This conference is so talented all around. There's no one guaranteed winner. And even as you said, there's no one absolute berth in the NCAA tournament. It's going to come down to who wins the CAA championship. Because really, that's going to show who is best in this division, or in this conference, I should say. And right now, UNCW and Delaware are putting in their best efforts to get to the semifinals, which will be held at Hofstra and played against Elon, a team that both teams are very familiar with.
And right now, looking at the other men's soccer quarterfinal match that is going on right now down at College of Charleston, the fifth seed visiting James Madison University Dukes up 2-0 over the Cougars of College of Charleston. That game is at halftime right now. We'll keep you updated. Those two teams, of course, on the other side of the bracket from these two teams. Talbot, towards the end line, cuts back.
In the other quarterfinal match tonight, at the half, Queen of Madison 2, out to Charleston.
You know, as we mentioned, that game now at 2-0 at the half. This game could very well have been 2-0 at the half, but thanks to Braden Smith, a fantastic running save. No credit to the goalie, because he basically lost himself. He tripped on himself, and it was a wide-open goal for Guillermo Delgado, and Braden Smith comes out of nowhere and keeps it out and then puts in the equalizer himself, and he's doing it all himself, and this game is at 1-1 rather than 2-0.
Dave Yardy looks like he wants to take a shot, and that one sails on the lefty. Goes wide. He had Carlos Perales on the wing, but saw Melvin a bit off his line and tried to sneak it past him. We're already 6 minutes gone by in the second half. Once again, this match brought to you by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer nearest you. And this Hens All Access broadcast of men's soccer is also being brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare. And for men's soccer, for the remainder of this season and going forward, you can follow them on Instagram and Twitter at Delaware M Sock. And also you can become a fan on Facebook at University of Delaware Men's Soccer. That one's headed along. Bylander collects. Now plays it forward, and Ben Sampson gets a crucial touch to that. Now plays it ahead. Bonner is there. Bonner. Morton comes out. Chips the goalie, and it goes wide. Bonner with another opportunity. Todd Morton yelling at his defense. Smart, he says. And really lucky that ball didn't find the back of the net. Morton came out. Thibaut Philippe retreated to try to cover the mouth of the goal. And the chip from Bonner goes wide of the net. And UNCW with two great chances here early.
Seriously, and for all of those who have followed the men's soccer team on Hens All Access throughout the season, you know that crossbar right there has been the saver and ruiner of some games. We've seen it make some crucial saves, and now that one just sailing over the top of that crossbar, keeping this game at 1-1.
Gillen. Plays it out wide. Talbot comes back to it. Chest it down. Joe Dupree has it now. Joe Dupree, through ball. Talbot is there. Delgado waiting in the middle. Talbot taken down in the box. No call. He was looking for one. Now Bonner traps it down to himself. The captain plays it out wide. Foster building up play here for the Seahawks. In yellow. And call there against the Hens. And Soren Frost, you see the freshman there, number 12. He's done a beautiful job on defense this season. On a back line that lost three key starters in Kyle Newell, Tobias Mueller, and Ignacio Martin. Garcia with the cross. Goes to the far corner of the box, headed away by Ben Sampson. Now Gillen plays it up. Was looking for Joe Dupree. Foster lofts it up in the air. Played ahead. Perales looking to keep it on his foot. Plays it ahead, and Delgado thinks he could have a chance to it. Sprinting towards it, and it looks like it might sail out of bounds. It does. Good defense there by Nally in the back left corner.
And a ball that was chipped up way into the air. At first, Guillermo Delgado just kind of watched it sail away, and then he realized, oh my goodness, I might have a play on this, so he took off. And unfortunately was unable to run down the UNCW defender, but that's the mindset of Guillermo Delgado. Any ball is a possibility at a goal, and he took off on that one opportunity that he saw. Unfortunately, couldn't catch up to it.
Played back, UNCW's offensive side. Won by Robert Gillen, and now Matt Morgan comes out of the back end to win that one back for the Seahawks. Both teams fighting for possession now, at transferring back and forth between the two squads. Now Gillen has some room in the middle of the field. He'll take it and get it up to Daviardi. Perales to his right, gets in the middle of the field. And plays it forward, upset with himself on that ball. Was trying to get it to Ryan Talbot. Bylander. Into Garcia. Nally. Goodwin. With a little bit of space, leaves it back, and Daviardi takes it away. Nice little move there. Gets it up to Joe Dupree. Joe Dupree back to Talbot. Delaware looking to mount a run here. Good ball up to Delgado. Delgado touches it along. It's going towards the corner. And he will win a corner for the Hens. Great hustle there by the captain. Generating offense. So it'll be a Delaware corner there first of the second half. Tomas Daviardi coming up to take it.
We saw Delaware score their first goal off a corner kick after their 75th try not too many games ago. We're hoping that it doesn't take as many tries to put one in here.
That's a dangerous one. Far post, still bouncing around, and it's in! Soren Frost, the freshman, puts Delaware up 2-1. Victimized by a corner in the first half. Champions of the corner in the second. They're up 2-1.
Right as I say it, they take advantage. And it, I mean, you have to take advantage of those corner kicks. Yeah. And what a time to do it. Early on in the second half, as we said it again, they take the advantage early and run with it. And now they're up 2-1. Just a fantastic play overall. Delaware doing a great job of fighting off the defenders. Guillermo Delgado starting this and creating an opportunity. As it rattles around in the middle, and Soren Frost just chips it in from right at the six-yard line. And this game is 2-1.
Hey, rookie, what a time for your first goal as a Blue Hen in the quarterfinals in a deadlocked match in the CAA postseason. Ben Sampson, I believe, will get credit for the assist there. His second of the season. We'll take another look at it now. That from a back angle, and Soren Frost didn't even know what to do. He gets mobbed right by his teammates. Delaware now once again protecting a one-goal lead. Talbot lets that one roll by, and it goes out of bounds off Bylander. Now the goal scorer will have the throw-in. We now see Danny Laguna, number 22, into the game for the Hens. Another scoring threat, part of this deep bench that Coach Hennessy is proud to have. So now Joe Dupree, Laguna, Delgado, and Dave Yardy all up there and able to put the ball in the back of the net, but it ends up being a freshman who's never scored before, putting Delaware up by a goal.
You know something, Kyle? It doesn't matter who it comes from. It just matters that it goes in. And what a great job by the entire team. Guillermo Delgado setting up the corner kick, and then Soren Frost taking advantage of the ball bouncing around in the middle. And now for UNCW, aside from the outstanding Delaware defense, time has become an enemy. And you're going to start to see that physicality come out like you saw at the right after Guillermo Delgado's goal in the first half, where UNCW is going to be literally fighting for the next goal.
And another update on that James Madison College of Charleston score. The Dukes have scored again, now up 3-0 over the four seed in the 54th minute of that one. And Delaware has reached that magic number. That would be two goals. They have not lost when scoring two goals this season. They are 8-0-1. Still a lot of time to play here. UNCW, a very talented team. Goodwin, cross. That one, Escobar was able to get a touch on it. Morton comes out and falls on it. Morton crushes that one forward. Delgado gets up. Schroeder controls it, plays it back to Joe Dupree. Delaware maintains possession now. Dupree with it again. He'll play it all the way back to Bo Philippe, now out wide. Talbot, Dave Yardy calling for it. Foster wins it back. Now Talbot plays it along. Delgado with some room. Plays it along to Joe Dupree. Dupree, one touch, to his right. Takes a shot, and that one sails high. The senior from Betchworth, England, had a good chance at it there. Score holds at 2-1. Morgan lofts it forward. Talbot traps it. Foster on his back. Back heel to Danny Laguna, who looks like he wasn't quite ready for it, or maybe the pass just a little off his line. Taken back. Fisher. Played out wide. Schroeder comes out of nowhere to come get that one. Schroeder plays in the middle of the field. Drags back, gets tripped up a little bit, stays on his feet. Here's to Bo Philippe. Escobar putting on some considerable pressure. Frost. Dave Yardy keeps it on his foot. Danny Laguna making the run, and he tried to get it to Delgado, who was sprinting up the middle of the field. Step for step with him was Nally. Now Talbot, quick throw. taking his space, middle of the field. Talbot's going to take a shot. That one sails just over the crossbar. The sophomore had a great look at Cage. Now we're going to get a replay there of the Joe Dupree shot. Wasn't as close as the shot we just saw. Colin Bonner checking back into the game. Headed backwards. Escobar has it now. Still with it. Heads it along. And Daviardi gets a big right foot to it. And call there against UN. Actually, looks like it might be an offsides call. We're going to get a replay there of the Talbot shot. You see him there. Great look at goal. And, oh, that one was real close. So an offsides there against Delgado.
I think that even scared Melvin a little bit when he looked back and saw how close it ended up being.
That one headed along beautifully to the foot of Joe Dupree, but he can't corral it, and it goes out of play. Foster to Bonner, chest it down. Back to Bonner now. Looking to get a foot free. Goes forward, and the offsides flag is raised. Also, fans, this CAA tournament is going on. Another Blue Hens team, the number 15th ranked University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens field hockey team, in the CAA championship tomorrow against the number one seed James Madison down in Harrisonburg, Virginia. That game will be at 2:00. The Hens looking to win their third straight CAA championship and gain a berth to the NCAA tournament. So a lot of Blue Hen athletes with postseason aspirations, championship aspirations, and very legitimate ones at that. Daviardi, Talbot, Frost plays it ahead, looking for Laguna. Can he get his body in position? Morgan does a nice job kicking it away. Daviardi gets up, back to Laguna, who tries to flick it along to Guillermo Delgado. You're under 26 minutes remaining in regulation. Once again, fans, thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening with us and the Hens All Access team alongside Andrew Wickman. I'm Kyle Coulter. You're watching the CAA quarterfinal match between the 6th seed UNCW Seahawks and your 3 seed University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Talbot. And that one gets cut out by Foster before it can reach its intended target, which was Danny Laguna. Fisher to his left, plays it ahead. That was a dangerous ball in, but it was too far for Bonner to get to, as well as Cromer charging up the left-hand side.
With Bonner's stature, I'm surprised he just didn't stick out his leg. He would have gotten to it with his leg span, standing at 6'3". That's tough to defend against when you stand that tall.
Absolutely. Here comes the kick from another tall man, Todd Morton. That one's flicked on, Soren Frost. He'll let it roll to his keeper. Schroeder plays it ahead. Smith does a nice job retreating there, gets in position. That won't go out of play. Off the Seahawks, Delaware will earn the throw. Bylander plays it back. Now up for Bonner. Sails over the head. Morton boots it away. And a call there against Robert Gillen. And That's an interesting matchup there. Bonner standing at 6'4", and I'd say probably 210 pounds around there, or very, very big size. And Robert Gillen, not a big young man at all. Probably standing around 5'8 or 5'9". And yet it's Gillen who gets the call against him. And that's a nice delivery there from Garcia. He's been putting the ball in very dangerous positions tonight. Speaking of which, now in the box, there's the shot just missed by Braden Smith, looking for his second of the night. Couldn't quite get enough on it. And Morton comes out, picks it up. Morton boots it away. Goes over the head of Talbot. Foster corrals it in. Now Bylander. Escobar plays it back. Now Bylander has it again in the midfield. Getting pressure by Daviardi. And Tomas Daviardi gets the call. Still no card shown tonight. It's been a good game, a well-officiated game, I believe. And there's the shot by Braden Smith. Unable to really connect on it the way he would have hoped. Joe Dupree wins it back. Getting pulled a little bit from behind, still with it on his foot, and it's won back by the Seahawks. Cromer gives it away. Daviardi has it on his foot. Daviardi still with it. Beats two defenders, trying to beat a third, and gets caught up. He goes down there on the sideline. Foster. That one deflects back to Fisher. Fisher with it again. Looks like he wants to take a shot. That time he does! And it goes wide. I believe it was deflected off of Soren Frost and went out of play. So UNCW will earn another corner. They, of course, scored off a corner in the first half, making it 1-1. A lot of threats, a lot of height there in the box for the Seahawks. It'll be Garcia. We see the shot there again. It deflects wide. Now the corner coming in. Morton comes out and punches it away. Good job there by the keeper. Garcia still has it out wide, and he plays it back into the box. It's settled. Cromer ends up giving it away. Delgado coming back to try to win it. He does. Escobar settles. Cromer trying to keep it on his foot. Robert Gillen with some aggressive defense. UNCW still with it. There's the cross, and Morton puts his hands up, doesn't even bother with it. It goes out of play.
Morton unsuccessful on the first punch out when UNCW was able to capitalize on their first corner or one of their corners in the first half, but this time much more successful punching it away and keeping another goal out of UNCW's score spot on the scoreboard, for lack of better things to say.
And number 20, Matt John Fortone, the freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina, checks back into the game. Here's John Fortone with it now. Plays it out wide. Fisher. Gillen wins it. One touch along. Danny Laguna with some room. He's got Delgado to his left. Delgado trying to stay on sides. And UNCW does a nice job holding their line, and they win it back. UNCW's really dominated possession here the last few minutes. We're under 20 minutes remaining in regulation. Delaware with that all-important one-goal lead. Morgan again with it. Chips it ahead. Leap to Gillen. Loses it. Escobar. Nifty little play there. He gets it back. Now Gillen slides in and wins it back for Delaware. Some scrappy play. That one played forward. Can Laguna get in front of Morgan? He does. Delgado to his left. Delgado. He has it. There's a shot. And it's in. Number 9 with number 3. Delaware up 3-1. The assist from Danny Laguna, and the captain, the All-American, the preseason CAA Player of the Year, comes through, and that is a massive, massive goal.
And this time when Sean Melvin comes out to try to snag Guillermo Delgado's run at the goal, nobody is there to back him up, and he just puts his one right there in the back of the corner, and Delaware takes a 3-1 lead.
Andrew, that ball felt like it was rolling towards the goal for an eternity. I wasn't sure if it was going to go just wide, hit the pipe, but it finds the bottom right corner. And Guillermo Delgado has his 10th goal of the season. He now stands alone in second place in points all time for the University of Delaware with 84. And inches closer to the all-time lead in goals. And I'm sure he's not thinking about those records right now. He's just thinking about the time left on this clock, which is now under 19. Let's take another look at it again. The slow-mo, Melvin gets a hand to it. He looks back. And he puts his head down, just couldn't get enough on it. That's got to be tough for the keeper. Danny Laguna with the assist. His second of the season. My goodness, Guillermo Delgado, what can you say? As you see the crowd there, docile now, but I'll tell you, they were rocking when that ball hit the back of the net.
That goal couldn't have come at a better time because UNCW really had mounted a few good opportunities. Two corner kicks that came very close and a few other opportunities where Todd Morton was really tested, but Guillermo Delgado comes and puts an end to that terror and gives the Hens a two-goal cushion.
Thibaut Philippe plays it out. And certainly that goal, not the nail in the coffin, but the hammer on its way down. There's the ball. And the Seahawks win a corner. They've been really dangerous from this position so far tonight. Garcia has done an outstanding job putting the ball in places where his teammates can make a play on it. He's going to look to do so here again. There's the cross. It's low. And headed away, not out of the danger just yet. John Fortone, Munn, gets some pressure from behind, loses it. Dupree can't quite keep it on his foot, and it'll travel back to Morgan. Out wide to Foster. That one played towards the goal, and Morton comes out. And grabs it with those big mitts. Now approaching 16 minutes remaining in regulation. Once again, the winner of this match goes and takes on Elon up in Hempstead, Long Island. That game will be November 13th, which is next Friday. And the championship game would be that Sunday, November 15th. Garcia plays it back.
Daddy, stop being attached to my phone. Wait.
Where are you guys going?
And in just 30 seconds, Delaware will pass that 30-minute threshold into the second half where UNCW does most of their damage. And now it's Laguna trying to play it to Delgado, but it goes behind the goal scorer. Delgado has four game-winning goals on the season. But because Soren Frost did get the second goal, neither of his goals would be considered the game winner, but still no one's going to tell you that they weren't both important. And that one played ahead. Laguna's going to be able to keep it in bounds. Back to Talbot. Talbot with some room. Knocked away by Morgan again. Middle of the field for Gillen. Daviardi. Dupree plays it back, and Schroeder has to come back. He was going to try to make a play offensively. There's Gillen. Near side, Talbot taking his space on the near side. Now cuts it back in the middle. Lagunas to his left. Chips it over. Lovely ball. Joe Dupree, edge of the box. To his left, now back for Gillen. Delaware, no rush. There's Danny Laguna again. Plays it ahead for Daviardi. Can he keep it in bounds? He does. Low cross. And Melvin smothers it, and it rolls along the mouth of the goal, but the keeper gets to pick it up. That one looked like it had eyes for the goal.
It did, and then it almost had a second opportunity at eyes for a goal. Thankfully, Melvin got away with one because no Hen was around to knock back the roller. But definitely another goal-scoring opportunity for the Hens.
Taking a look at it there, Daviardi. Beautiful cross in that. The spin, luckily, was going away. Took the ball away from the goal. That could have been catastrophic for the Seahawks. Gillen gets taken down, but a play on is called. Talbot, edge of the box. He's got some room. Wants to take a shot, and that one's deflected off Morgan. Matt Morgan, the freshman from Johns Creek, Georgia, coming back and making a play. Daviardi. Gillen. Maybe that's Talbot. Now Gillen. Delgado. Plays it up. Danny Laguna. He's got Schroeder to his right. Danny Laguna still with it. Lefty shot. Knocked down. Still in front of the cage. Joe Dupree is there. And he gets taken down from behind. They're going to call it a corner. So Delaware with another opportunity. Not only for a goal, but to take 30, 45 seconds off his clock.
Yeah, when Melvin just punched that out instead of trying to hold on to it, Joe Dupree had a very good opportunity, but then the UNC defender came and chopped it away with a nice slide tackle. But yet another goal-scoring opportunity now for the Hens, and only 12 minutes left. The Seahawks are going to have to make anything happen at this point and really get things firing if they're going to want a shot.
That cross harmless. Now Daviardi gets it back. Cross, it gets knocked down. And a good play by Thibaut Philippe coming out of the back end to win that back for the Hens. Ben Sampson has it now. Out of his natural position, but he still has it. Certainly capable in the offensive end. Keeps it on his foot in the corner. He's fine with keeping it there. And it's kept in bounds. Now with the center back out of position, Delaware's going to have to compensate. Daviardi has run back. UNCW looking to counter. And that one goes off. It's like the hand of Daviardi. Maybe also the face, but he looks like he's okay. Good through ball, but Thibaut Philippe is right there to take it away. Talbot. Delgado. Delgado turning on that second notch of speed. Wants to play it to himself. And it was close. Sean Melvin able to come out and kick it away.
You know something, Kyle? It really is amazing to see how fast he is when he just has open field and a rolling ball. It's like he has jets on his heels. It's incredible, really.
Very, very few players I've seen can give themselves that big of a touch and still be able to recover before another player from the other team can get to it. But Guillermo Delgado is certainly one of those players with that caliber of talent. There's a ball in right to Morton. Who falls down on it. Ten minutes remaining now in regulation. Delaware with a 3-1 win. And eyes on CAA championship weekend. Danny Laguna settles under it. Delgado's in the middle. Laguna plays it back to Joe Dupree. Now one touch back to Laguna, still with it now. And Munn has it, and that will go out of bounds. Be another Delaware corner.
It seems like the Seahawks are on their heels at this point, and it's sad to see because they played a fantastic game aside from a few mistakes on defense, and that really is what hurt them. Obviously, I mean, it'll hurt anybody if you make few defensive mistakes, but much credit to the UNCW defense throughout the game.
Dave Yardy, Joe Dupree coming over. Casey wants to play it short, just take some time off the clock. But he decides to go for Cage, and that one sails long, and Talbot unable to get to it. And it rolls out of play. Looks like Nick DiRienzo checking back into the game. They'll take out Davey Artie. And not sure if his night's finished or not, but if it is, certainly had a heck of a night. Getting congratulations from his teammates. He assisted on the first goal, and it's just been a menace in the midfield. That ball off the head of Soren Frost. John Fortone. There he is with it again. Taking it to the middle of the field. Crossed. Munn. Morgan. Trying to get it back into the offensive third. They do. Here's Garcia with the cross. It's high. It's lofted. Morton's going to come out and punch it away. He does. Avoids a nasty collision there, but Zero comes out and does his job. Low ball play. John Fortone tries to corral it in. It's one back by Gillen. One touch. And Talbot gets taken down. The call obviously against the Seahawks. No card is shown. And you saw it coming from a mile away. Foster was charging hard to try to win that ball back. And credit to the ref, he made the call, didn't show a card. And the clock will be stopped here for the moment as Todd Morton comes up to take the kick. 7 minutes, 25 seconds stand between the University of Delaware and a slot in the semifinals against Elon, a team that they lost to 1-0 when Elon was ranked as the eighth best team in the country right here at Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. And that was also an incredibly exciting game. That was right in the middle of Delaware's lull when they weren't scoring at all. And they scored three goals over seven games.
And now, with 7 minutes left to play in the second half, they have three goals tonight.
Very astute observation there, Andrew. So hopefully they can, if the score holds, which it's looking like it will, barring a absolutely incredible comeback by the Seahawks. Laguna, take a shot, deflected. Laguna still has it in his possession. Turns, quick cross, still there in the box. And that ball goes off the face of DiRienzo. Looks like there's a Seahawk down. That's Escobar with the advantage on. Delaware still going. Joe Dupree making a run, it's into the box. And kicked away, Escobar down. They're just in the middle of the field. It looks like they're going to bring the training staff out. Hopefully he's all right, the senior from Cali, Columbia. He's had himself a fine night. You see Coach Hennessy there, that's a happy man. Definitely pleased with the way his team has played tonight. I would imagine. Well, Jimmy Smith will be able to talk to him after the game as well. And just a reminder, you've seen UD men's soccer at the top of their match. At the top of their game, make sure you try to keep them there. Contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund and support the 21 varsity sports at UD. All contributions go towards scholarships, facilities, and many more. Go to bluehens.com/UDAF. Looks like Escobar is up and walking around. We see some young fans there. I see dressed in blue and gold, so they're happy. And hey, there's us up in the box. No one wants to see us. Go back to the game. There we go. It's certainly been an exciting match to call. Thank you so much for sticking with us here on Hens All Access. This match powered by your local Chevy dealer. Make sure you visit ChevyDealer.com to find a dealer nearest you. And Delgado will play it back to Melvin. We'll get things restarted here with just over 6 minutes left in regulation. UNCW really needs the push now. Bonner. And it goes right back Delaware's way. Talbot plays it ahead. Delgado is going to try to get there, but Melvin comes out wisely to kick it away. He definitely doesn't won't underestimate the speed of Delgado anymore. And there's a nice ball up to Laguna. Nick DiRienzo joining the run. Far side, good looking pass. Delgado has Talbot to his left. Delgado still with it towards the end line. Melvin comes out and smothers it. Nice job there again by Sean Melvin. Gillen. Talbot. Delgado's got to get back on sides. He knows he can't touch that ball. So Melvin, take it outside the box. No pressure on him. Trying to jumpstart an attack going the other way. This was FIFA, I believe. Their game strategy right now would be on park the bus. Or just you just collapse all the defense and the midfielders in. But now here's another chance for Cromer. Cromer, cross towards the middle. The ball's lofted up and Morton comes and grabs it. Before Nathaniel Goodwin can come in and try to make a play on it.
Whenever it seems that we have put Delaware really, as you said before, nailing it into the coffin, UNCW shows a little sign of life, putting something to scare the Hens, but under 4.5 left to play, it's really going to have to be an absolute showing of goals now for UNC to have a sniff.
This is a very proud team. This is a team who earned an at-large bid to the NCAA tournament last year, won the program's first ever NCAA tournament game last year. So they know how to win, and they know what success tastes like, and they're not going to go down easy here in the last few minutes. I expect them to fight with everything they have. But right now, Delaware trying to make it what would be an insurmountable lead. Talbot. Step over to his right. Shot deflected, and that one goes out of play. It'll be another Delaware corner, and that one will take some time off the clock. Precious, precious seconds for this Seahawks squad, and this crowd can sense it. It's chilly out on the field. This Delaware team has been red hot. And no, that is not a thunderstorm rolling in. That is the feet of the crowd. Here's Talbot. Lovely step over move there, and Garcia is able to get a foot to it. And the clock will stop for three UNCW substitutions. Joe Dupree standing there, and Nick DiRienzo as well. Two seniors. Waiting to get the final 3 minutes and 4 seconds underway. And the clock will be set back to 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And now they get restarted. Nick DiRienzo holding it right in the corner there. And it's still in bounds. Whole ball has to be over the line, and now it finally goes over. Clock still running. Subs come in. That's Cordero checking back into the game. I'll see number 6, David Lozano, the freshman from Gastonia, North Carolina. And number 11, Ben Fisher, back into the game. Two minutes, 45 seconds remaining here in regulation. Delaware with a 2-goal lead. And then that other match, with just about 8 minutes remaining, James Madison with a 3-1 lead over the College of Charleston in the other quarterfinal match. The winner of that game will take on the number one seed, Hofstra. Two minutes, 10 seconds. Cordero has it blocked back. It's a foot race. Talbot looking to get to it, but Cordero has the step. And he'll keep it in the possession of UNCW. Headed along. Danny Laguna gets it back for the home team. That one goes off the Seahawks. Here's the throw. Joe Dupree with it, and a handball there comes up. Catches the senior in the arm. UNCW restarts it with a minute and 20 seconds. Their season ended on this field just about a year ago in the semifinal match. And it's a minute away from ending once again on this same turf.
The crowd can feel it now, Kyle. It's a really good feeling.
And I can feel the crowd feeling it. And stomping their feet on the metal stands here. Todd Morton boots that one away. 45 seconds now. Played out wide. Talbot's going to keep that one in bounds. Take it to the corner. No need to go for goal. Just looking to waste some time. Talbot puts it out. 25 seconds remaining. Will be a goal kick. The applause starting. 18 seconds now. Lofted up in the air. Nick DiRienzo wins it back. Plays it forward. And it looks like that will do it, ladies and gentlemen. There will be another match for this University of Delaware Blue Hens men's soccer team in this 2015 season. That man right there, the captain, number 9, with 2 goals on the night. And that's the margin that Delaware wins this quarterfinal matchup by. 3-1 over the UNCW Seahawks. Their season has ended with a final record of 8-8-3. And Delaware improves to 10-6-3 overall. And they have a date with a team that beat them right here on this field a couple months ago by a score of 1-0, the Elon University Phoenix.
Kyle, just an incredible game and incredible for the Hens overall. When they are reeling at a time in mid-season when they need to get things going, they do, and in the last few weeks of the season, they really get hot, and what a better no better time to get hot than right now, and now coming out with a huge win. Guillermo Delgado putting in 2 goals, the leader all season, just none better than Guillermo Delgado and these Hens putting together a fantastic show. 3-1 win off to Elon, or off to play Elon at Hofstra.
And right now we're going to send it down to Jimmy Smith, who is with the winning coach down on the field. Take it away, Jimmy.
All right, your best soccer is being played right now, Coach. Unbelievable effort. That's the goal effort we were looking for this year.
Yeah, well, that's, you know, the second half, I think. It was a tale of two halves, but the second half today, I thought we were terrific. And, you know, 13 shots and three great goals today. So you're right, we're peaking at the right time, and hopefully we can roll into Long Island next week and continue that form.
Yeah, we go on and on about Guillermo Delgado. He's got to finish it, right? But Thomas De Bellardi and Danny Laguna really stepping up, more of an offensive role, specifically for Thomas, really stepping in and playing a big offensive role. What's been going right for those two guys?
Well, I think at the start of the season, we spoke, Jim, and I said, you know, it takes any college coach, I think, a good 6-7 games to know who they are and establish that rhythm. I think we just fine-tune a couple of things, give Thomas a little bit more freedom. Robert has done a great job stepping in for us, and I think, you know, when they get a sense of each other's cadences and get a feel for each other, it really sets a tone for the squad. And I think just those two and a couple of others toward the middle and end of the season really have changed things for us. So,
Todd Morton, end of sentence. Thoughts on him?
Todd's been great. You know, he's continued to grow. and there's a ways to go for Todd and the back four, and but I think again, you know, with the minutes played and the back four in front of him with Tebow and Ben in particular, and the two young lads on each flank, I think as a unit there, they've really started to hit their stride now toward the end of the season, which we need. So yes, it's a big weekend for us.
Well, I'm going to go find your two goal scorers and your senior Joe Dupree, who got in the mix as well. Congratulations. Go celebrate with the team.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Jim.
All right, back up to you guys, and I'll go find these guys.
All right, thanks, Jimmy. We're going to throw it back down to you in a minute. And there's a happy young fan right there. He probably has no idea what just went on, but he's having a great time down on the field. Is that a bear? Is
I don't know,
fan?
But he looks quite warm.
He does look warm. We need to get ourselves one of that. But speaking of warm and actually really hot, this Delaware men's soccer team right now, they have not tasted defeat in almost a month. Their last loss coming October 10th, when they took on Hofstra. They've since beaten Drexel 5-1, Northeastern 3-2, Maryland 2-1, tied UNCW 1-1, beat James Madison 4-0, William & Mary 3-1, and now another 3-1 victory. In those games, they have outscored their opponents 21-7. It's been outstanding. And now we see Jimmy Smith is down on the field with the goal scorer, Guillermo Delgado. Take it away, Jimmy.
Thank you, guys, here with Joe Dupree. Senior year, you didn't want it to end here, and guess what, it doesn't. How's that feel?
Incredible. Obviously, every game from now can be my last, so I've got to give absolutely everything, and we really battled today. We deserve the win.
This offensive effort is what we've seen in the past. It's not what we saw in the beginning of this year. What's changed?
Well, I think we had a few new faces coming in, and it took us a while to find our rhythm. And again, with soccer, so much momentum. You know, we've 8 games unbeaten now. We believe we can win. We believe we can score, and it's a confidence thing, I think, more than anything.
You got Elon up next. 2 incredible games against them the last two times out. Both. What about that team really brings the best out in you guys?
I don't know, really. I mean, they're always, since joining our conference a couple of years ago, they've always been strong. They've always been up there competing for the championship, and make or break game against those guys, so we're very excited for it.
Well, congratulations. Excited to see 14 one more time out there.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Pri, I'm going to go find Guillermo for you guys.
Well, thanks a lot, Jimmy. And I thought that was Guillet from up top, but that was Joe Dupree, the senior, who's been on this team the last 4 years. He's seen the lows, he's seen the highs, and he's just a force on this team. And now we're going to throw it. We have one more interview for you as we look at Ryan Talbot here again on a replay. Talbot to his left, back over right. That was the shot that got deflected and went out of play as Jimmy and Guillet get back set up for yet another interview. And now 2 goals on the night, and he is with our Jimmy Smith. Take it away, Jimmy.
Thank you, guys. Guillermo Delgado, 2 goals today. It just looks like this team is completely different from what we saw in the beginning. What's going right, and what's going well for you?
Well, we were just working hard throughout all the season, and now we've peaked and on the most important time of the year, and we're here to win everything.
How nice was it to give those two seniors another game, another chance for another CIA championship?
It was amazing. That was actually one of the things we talked before we went out, just fighting for those who are not going to be able to play anymore, or like, for example, Jaime, who's senior again this season. So just like working as a family and getting them rings, important for us this year.
Now, obviously, Elon's the next opponent. What? They're such a good team. And the last two times out, you know, here, it was the first game at the Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium as we know it now. Hugely emotional game. You got the win. And then here, earlier, lose to them 1-0. What about them brings the best in you guys and brings the best out of you?
Well, we're two very similar teams. We both like to play the ball, so that's going to make it an interesting game and fun to play. And we're here to fight for it. I don't think they're ready for us.
All right, well, congratulations. Go enjoy it with your team.
Perfect. Thank you.
That's Guillermo Delgado. One more. I'm going to get Soren Frost for you guys.
And the hits just keep on coming. Thanks a lot, Jimmy. And you heard it there from Guillermo Delgado. I happen to agree with him. I don't think they're ready for us. And that's a powerful statement, but with a lot of confidence. And why not? This team is so hot right now. Guillermo Delgado really hitting his stride. See Soren Frost jogging over there. And they're gonna go up and take on the co-regular season champs, University of Phoenix. Elon University Phoenix, as I said. Sorry about that. But now we're going to toss it back. It's getting late. We're going to toss it back down to Jimmy Smith, who was with the goal scorer who had the game winner, and that's Soren Frost, the freshman. Take
it
away,
guys.
Jimmy.
I don't know we've officially met yet, Mr. Frost, but congratulations. That first goal, how'd that feel?
It felt amazing. I mean, just coming in here as a freshman, I couldn't have asked for anything more. I think Benny did all the work, Benny Sampson, but
stop.
I was just in the right place at the right time just to finish, so it was an awesome feeling.
How nice is it to give those guys another chance? Obviously, Ben has a fifth year. He'll come back, but you know, this very well could have been his last game. But for Joe and for the other seniors out there, how nice is it to give Nick DiRienzo and Joe Dupree another game?
It's great because, I mean, they're just great guys. They make the locker room so much more fun. I mean, they lead us on and off the field, and it's just great to be able to give back and provide for them.
How about the crowd today? Obviously, this is what you wanted. This is why you came here. This is what it was billed as, and it really lived up to it.
Yeah, I mean, it was amazing. The crowd just elevated the whole game. I mean, we came out a little slow, but I think they kept us in it. We scored, and they just exploded, and it just lifted our spirits and everything, so it was great.
Congratulations. Enjoy the trip to Hofstra. Let's see two games.
All right, thanks.
That's awesome. Soren Frost. Back up to you guys.
And what a time for his first goal as a Blue Hen, the game winner off a corner. He gave credit to Ben Sampson. The selfless freshman there giving credit to the senior captain who did do a lot, got the assist, his second of the season. And we'll take a look at Elon. They're coming in. They beat College of Charleston and then lost to Radford in an out-of-conference matchup. And then they have a lot of time to prepare for this Delaware team, and that's what they're going to need. They're going to need time to prepare for this team because they can come at you in so many ways, as we've seen.
And it's almost beneficial for Elon to have this game a week from, or well, I should say less than a week, but still a good amount of time away from today. And that's going to hurt Delaware because they're in full stride right now. And to have 6 days of rest, while that could be good for their legs, it's not so good for their momentum because they're really firing on all cylinders. And that's tough to sit out for so many days when you have to regroup and have a very tough test of Elon in the semifinals.
Well, I'm really sorry. This is very sad for me to say that this will be the last time this season that this Delaware team plays here at this stadium. They've been so electric to watch. The crowd is great tonight. As Soren Frost mentioned, they really came out and supported this team, and they saw a great victory. And as Jimmy said, hopefully they can see at least two more games. Guillermo said they peaked. I hope the ascent is still climbing. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching tonight. We had Josh Deal on camera, also Nina Raspa, Jimmy Smith on camera, and our on-field correspondent. Up top, we had Mike Hutz, Lauren Rubich, and Aaron Anderson. We also had Brad Wolak directing, Emma Sills on replay, Alyssa Spence producing, Andrew Wickman was to my right. I'm Kyle Coulter. Thank you so much for listening, ladies and gentlemen, and until next time, have a great night, everybody.